Hey everybody, thank you for tuning in to Small Business Saturdays with Urbane Market. My name is Malik Wasim, and today we're here with Rocky Collins of Cali Handsome. And he's here to tell us a bit about his brand and what helped him start this brand. So Rocky, tell us a little bit about what inspired you and how did you get started?
Yeah, well, first off, thank you guys for having me here. So my brand is Cali Handsome. It's a men's grooming brand. And I mean, in the simplest way, it started because I was looking for a premium skincare experience for me, and a lot of my other Black friends were looking for one as well. And the products that were on the market were not really giving what they were supposed to give. They were not doing what they were supposed to do. So it just got to the point where I'm like, look, like, I want a premium experience. I want a luxury skincare experience. And if I cannot find one, I'm gonna make one. And yeah, that's essentially how you got started.
So yeah. What were you doing at the moment where you decided to say, hey, I'm just gonna start this line? Like, what triggered you? A lot of business owners have that moment I'm just gonna do it.
Well, there was two triggers. One was frustration. Like I said before, I couldn't find an experience that I wanted out there. So it was the frustration part. And then it just timing. I ended up, at the time, I was doing a freelance job at L'Oreal, working for their men's grooming brand, Baxter, California, that's based in LA. And so I was having all this knowledge and research, doing all the skincare stuff anyway. So that mixed with like the frustration of not being able to find something, I'm like, look, I have the knowledge. I'm already working in the skincare industry every day. So like between that and my frustration, like those two things combined, I think was like the catalyst for me to get started.
Nice, nice. So what would you say your hero product is? Like, what's your favorite product from your line?
Oh, that's a hard one. I mean, by far is our MVP beard pencil. I think that is the latest product that we dropped back in January. And because it's so different, and I think people are kind of blown away by like what it even is. So essentially it's a beard filler, so you can line your beard and fill in any patchy areas just, you know, simply, easily from your bathroom whenever you want it. I like to call it like my Fresh Cut Friday whenever I want it. And that has by far been a superstar. And I honestly was very nervous because I didn't think people would understand it. I thought people might have been turned off by it. They might have thought it was too much like a makeup or a cosmetic tool. But since launching in January, it's literally been our number one product. Unit sales, dollar sales. It's the most shared product on social media. It's like crazy. Like that company, that product that I was so nervous to put out literally changed the game for my company in terms of like profitability and scalability. So that is by far like the superstar and the hero. But I think from the core skincare collection, like my favorite is just the face wash, just because like we sourced this seaweed, this algae in France, and I went like very far and very beyond to like really get a premium like face wash. And I think that was like the number one product that I was looking for in the beginning that I didn't find. And so to have it and have been able to develop it with the ingredients that we were able to source, still produced in the USA, by the way. So that's probably my special little baby.
Okay. So I know you mentioned the pencil is very revolutionary and game-changing. Yeah. And the face wash, the ingredients, this, what is it, seaweed? Or
yeah, algae.
Yes, algae. Yeah. So what is it that makes, what does it do for the skin, or what makes it different than any other thing on the market?
Yeah. So it's like the properties of algae alone, because it's grown so deep in the sea, is naturally like a moisturizing agent. But what people don't know, it's also a very strong cleansing agent. Okay. So you have something that's super strong at like cleansing and good for your skin, but it's also naturally hydrating. Gotcha. So you get that super deep clean, and I work out a lot, like 2 times a day, and I have something that's really going to get in there, get all that sweat, get all that oils out, but it's going to like hydrate my skin at the same time. And that is essentially what I was desperately trying to find before, but didn't. Either something cleaned my skin and left it dry, or left it moisturized but didn't really give me a good clean. So and that's why I was so focused on like finding an ingredient like the algae that we have. So I'm happy that we were able to get it. It is a bit more expensive, which, you know, which is why our price points are where they are, but it is what it is. Like, you get what you pay for. If you want your $8 Target face wash, you will get that $8 Target experience. But if you want a luxury experience and a premium skincare package, like, that is who we're servicing. So
Well, that makes sense. And what type of challenges have you faced as a business owner coming in and starting your brand? I know you mentioned that the pencil has done really well. Types of things have you tried to determine what's successful for your business?
Honestly, there's challenges every single day. I think the biggest challenges is kind of like finding how to get started. Mm-hmm. And finding a skincare production lab, I think, was a very huge challenge because a lot of the good labs don't want to work with smaller brands or new companies because they want you to be able to order 10,000 units off the bat, which we have not, and we still don't order 10,000 units at a time. And then some of the smaller labs that'll do that, they don't really let you customize because they're just like, it's not worth it to let you mix all these ingredients yourself. Mm. So finding a lab that allowed me to do both, to customize and order quantity sizes that were appropriate to being a new brand, mm-hmm. that was like such a huge challenge. So suppliers to me was like the biggest challenge. And then you can have the best product in the world, but if people don't know it, and if people don't mm-hmm. even, you know, give it a chance, like your business won't go anywhere. So right. after finding like the suppliers and stuff, the next thing is like getting people to try your product, mm-hmm. especially when your face wash is $34. Like people are like, what? You know what I mean? Like, I mean, I know you said seaweed, bro, but like, what?
I don't know what that is.
Yeah. So you really got to kind of like provide context for people and really like educate people a lot to even get them to try. But like, once people started trying, we started getting a lot of like mm-hmm. user generated content and reviews and stuff. Then it's like, all right, fine. Because now people are able to see like other guys are like, oh, nah, like this is really that work.
Right.
But those are probably the biggest two challenges. But like I said, new stuff pops up every single day. I mean, there's an inventory shortage right now. So that's a challenge this week.
So every day, every week is a new challenge to overcome. So it's kind of just like dealing with it, rolling with the punches.
Yeah, exactly.
Remembering why you're here and why you're doing this, right?
Exactly. Yeah.
So what type of advice would you have for anyone else who's trying to start a new brand or, you know, trying to figure out what their calling is in life?
The biggest thing I would say, I guess, is find something that you're passionate about and find a way to build a career out of it. And if you can tie your passion with a mission that's like bigger than you, then like you hit a gold mine. So for me, I've been passionate about skincare, you know, and wanting like better skincare experiences for myself. And then I just happened to find a way to make a business out of it. Mm-hmm. And then for me, it ties into a bigger mission because it's like, I'm not only making these products for myself, I'm like literally giving guys the tools to have the best skin of their lives. How you look impacts how you feel about yourself, and that impacts your confidence, your positive self-esteem, all that stuff. Yes. So for me, I'm not just selling skincare, I'm helping sell positive self-esteem and confidence for you to be the bossy version of yourself, to be that dude to go out there and to like just really be able to own your life on your own terms. So I would say for anybody that's thinking about starting a business or a company, find out what your passion is, find a way to make a business out of it, and then tie it into a mission that's bigger than you. You do those three things, like you'll be pretty set. It's still gonna be hard. It's still gonna be hard, but you're gonna be okay.
That's great advice. You know, I feel like that is something that every business owner needs to know. Anyone who's going into entrepreneurship, just follow your heart, figure it out, figure out what it is that makes your idea, product different, and how it can serve other people in that process. That's really where to start.
That's really it, honestly. And everything else just goes from there. But
yes. Well, thank you so much, Rocky. This was a great experience. I love it. I gotta try some of your skincare products. I'm on my own virtual right now, but I have to I have to try some of it. Definitely. So thank you for having us here, and we will talk soon. Thank you, everybody, for tuning in.
Thank you, guys.